Hi friends, in this video we are going to discuss critically endangered species. First let us know what are critically endangered species. First, species are classified into following types. First, extinct. Extinct means they are no more. There are also two types, extinct, extinct in wild. Extinct means they are no more in this planet. Extinct in wild means they are no more in their habitat. Habitat means the place where they are living, but they are present on the earth where on zoos and also some protection centers, two or three species like that. Extinct means entirely extinct. Extinct in wild means they are no more in their habitat place, they are present in zoos, two or three species. So entirely extinct means they are no more, like dinosaurs, all those things. Next, critically endangered. Critically endangered means they are threatened. They are going to extinct in near future. Endangered means they are also threatened, but they are going to extinct in some future. Vulnerable, they are also threatened. In next slide I will discuss about these three things: what are threatened, what are endangered, critical endangered, vulnerable, all those things. Next one, least concern. Least concern means they are not threatened. So these are the classifications: extinct, critically endangered, endangered, vulnerable, least concern. So for take an example, there are some animals, they are in huge in number and sufficient in number, they are considered as least concern. There is no threat to them, but somebody started poaching, and means hunting, so they become the population will decrease, they become vulnerable. So the threat is hunting, and the hunting continues, they become endangered, and they become the population again going drastically decreases, and they become critically endangered, and finally they extinct. That's why the stays continues. If government or any measures not taken, all they can extinct in near future. So let us see about critically endangered and vulnerable conditions. This is the criteria. Critically endangered, this is the criteria. Endangered criteria, vulnerable criteria. What is the criteria? What is the reduction in population in last 10 years? At present, what is the availability of number? So next, last one, probability of extinct. Next, first one, critically endangered, they are reduced more than 90% in last 10 years. Endangered, they are reduced 70% of population in last 10 years. Vulnerable, they are reduced 50% of population in last 10 years. Available in number, critically endangered, they are only 50, below 50. And endangered, they are available in number below 250. And vulnerable, they are available in number below 10,000. Probability of extinct. So in 10 years they can extinct if measures are not taken, and endangered in 20 years, and vulnerable in 100 years if measures are not taken. So who will take these measures? Then let us see IUCN. So what is this IUCN? What is the full form? The IUCN is nothing but International Union for Conservation of Nature. So what is the basic function means? We already discussed, take measures to protect those endangered animals or species. First let us discuss about IUCN. It is formed in 1948. For what purpose? For classification of species, either endangered or endangered, and also for provide the protection. The headquarters of IUCN is Gland, Switzerland. Remember guys, UPSC asking in this area, frequently asking questions in these areas. Next, they will issue red list. Red list means danger, endangered species, so covered in this list. We will discuss regarding this red list in a later slide. Next, IUCN firstly issued red list in 1966. So they will issue red list for the entire world, not with respect to specific country. They will issue red list for the entire world. Who will issue? IUCN. So in red list there are two types: pink list, green list. Pink list refers to critically endangered, we already discussed, and green list refers to endangered. We already discussed what is the difference between critically endangered and endangered. So pink list refers to critically endangered, green list refers to endangered. Next, generally IUCN issue for the entire world, But regarding country, so this is our country, India. So with respect to the country, the responsibility of protection of those species which are in red list is with respective countries. Respective countries has to take measures to protect those species. So our country is responsible to protect those species. Then what our country done? So a country drafted Wildlife Protection Act. So this act provides protection for wildlife animals, birds and plants, nothing but red list species. This act was passed in the year 1972. So this act was passed in the year 1972. So we will discuss about this act. Start. This act consists of 6 schedules. So first, schedule 1, schedule 2. They are critically endangered animals. So this act provides absolute protection. Here we can see. Critical schedule 1, schedule 2, absolute protection. Absolute protection and the high penalties when they are hunted. And next, schedule 3, schedule 4. They are endangered, not critically endangered, endangered. Protection is there, but low penalties when compared to abolished. Next, schedule 5, may be hunted. There is no protection, may be hunted. Next, schedule 6, prohibited for cultivation and plantation. This is specifically for certain species of plants, they are prohibited for cultivation. So these are the 6 schedules of Wildlife Protection Act 1972. So next, in this video I am going to discuss about critically endangered species. In next videos I will discuss about endangered and remaining things, but in this critically endangered I will discuss only mammals in this video. So not boats, mammals. Mammals means we already know mammals give birth to their babies and fed with milk and they have glands, all those things. They are mammals, not birds. So let us start. First, critically endangered mammals. First one, critically endangered animals in India. First one, pygmy hog. Actually, we are discussing critically endangered animals in India. First one, pygmy hog. This is a pygmy hog. This is critically endangered. So why? Reason. Let us see the reasons. So pygmy hog, about this pygmy hog, this is the world's smallest pig, wild pig, smallest pig. It is around 8 kgs and it is habited in grasslands. Next, mostly found in Manas. So it is found in Manas Wildlife Sanctuary. It is in Assam. Remember guys, it is found in Manas Wildlife Sanctuary. It is in Assam. Threats. What are the threats for their endangered? So loss of degradation of grasslands. Grasslands are decreasing because it is habitated in grasslands. So loss of degradation in grasslands and dry seasons are burning. Actually, due to dry seasons, grasslands are burning. So this is also one of the threat. And hunting is also one of the threat. These are the reasons for endanger of this species. Next, this is about pygmy hog. Next one. Screw is also critically endangered species. In that screw, white-toothed screw. This is a white-toothed screw. So next one, spiny screw. This is spiny screw. We can see the spines in the body. So next one, white-tailed screw. This is a white-tailed screw. So we can see the tail also, white tail. So these screws are critically endangered. So white-toothed screw is found in South Andaman, and the spiny screw is also found in South Andaman, but white-tailed screw is found in Nicobar. So what is the reason? Threat is habitat loss due to natural disasters. Habitat loss due to natural disasters like tsunami and climate change, all those things. Due to that reason, the threat to these species. Next one, Kondana rat. This is a Kondana rat. So let us discuss. This is also critically endangered in India. Let us discuss. Kondana rat is nothing but natural. Natural means they are active in nights. Daytime they are sleeping. They are active in nights. And rodent. Rodent means we can see in the rats actually two pairs of tooth in front jaw and upper jaw and lower jaw in front. Two tooth. So that is nothing but rodent. Generally found in rats. So found in these rats are found in India only. Endemic in India means they are native in India. They are found in India only, and they are found in Singar Plateau near Pune. And threats, what are those threats? Overgrazing of vegetation. Actually, it depends upon vegetation, overgrazing of vegetation and disturbance from tourism. Tourism disturbance also creating threat to the species. This is about Condona rat. Next one, lodge rock rat. Lodge rock rat is also critically endangered. We can see in this picture. Next, large details about lodge rock rat facts. Medium-sized mammal. It is a medium-sized mammal. Nocturnal, we already discussed. Nocturnal means active in night. Rodent. Rodent, we also discussed. It is nothing but two pair of tooth in upper jaw and lower jaw. Next, found in India only and eastern ghats of Tamil Nadu. They are found in, mostly found in eastern ghats of Tamil Nadu. Threats. What are the threats for extent? What are the threats for their endanger? Nothing but habitat loss and deforestation is the threat. This is about lodge rock rat. Next, endangered species. Namdapa flying squirrel. This is also critically endangered. So let us discuss the details. Namdapa squirrel facts. Facts are nothing but it is flying squirrel. It is flies in the centuries also. Next, found in. It is mostly found in Namdapa Tiger Reserve in Arunachal Pradesh. That's why it is called as Namdapa flying squirrel. Threats. What are the threats? Habitat loss due to natural disasters. So this is the reason. Natural disasters are the reason. Next one, Malabar civet. This is also critically endangered species. We can see a cat-like a mammal. And details, world's rarest mammal. It's a cat-like and wooden plains and hill slopes. They are found in wooden plains and hill slope. Found in India only. Threats. What are the threats? Deforestation, commercial plantation are the threats for the endangered. Next one. Sumatran rhinoceros. Actually, these are critically endangered species. Rhinoceros, one horn rhinoceros. Let us discuss the details. These rhinoceros found facts nothing but smallest and most endangered rhino. They are found in foothills of Himalayas and northeastern India. Reasons for threats. Poaching, hunting. Why these rhinos are hunting means that horn is used in medicines, they think. And also for ritual purpose. We can see the pictures. For horn purpose they are hunting, and also for ritual purpose, so they are hunting. So this is the reason. Next, Kashmir stag. This is found in Kashmir. So let us, this is also critically endangered. Let us see the details. Facts. Actually, state animal of Kashmir and subspecies of deer, found in India only. And also threats, overgrazing and poaching, hunting. So mainly hunting. So this is about a Kashmir stag. So these are all critically endangered animals. How can we remember? Means there is a shortcut. Let's see the shortcut. So PLS means please reach KKN Mall. Actually, KKN Mall here very famous in this place. So not all over India here. Actually, P for pygmy hong, L for large rock rat, S for screw, R for rhinoceros, K for Condona rat, another K for Kashmir stag, and for Namdapa flying squirrel, M for Malabar civet. This is a shortcut. Reach KKN Mall. If you know the better shortcut, please share it in comment section. That will help you too. That's all for this video. Share the video. Subscribe the channel for more videos. In next videos, I am going to discuss about critically endangered birds. Very, very important. UPSC asking questions in this area in every attempt. So, bye.